AI is absolutely everywhere these days. Every app has to have some AI features, whether it makes sense or not. And you'll be really happy to know that AI is also coming to the DevTools. But before you close this window, actually, this time it's really good. And this is, if you're asking me, how AI should work in any app. Stick to the end of this video and find out exactly how you can use AI features in Chrome DevTools today. All right, I have my site CSS stickers open, and let's explore if AI can help me fix some problems and potentially improve the site overall. I will open developer tools and I will go into settings. In the settings, you will find a new panel, AI innovations. If you open it, you will see information about how your data is being used and how AI features work, along with the features that are available. Currently, these are console insights, which help you understand and fix console warnings and errors, and AI assistance to give you help with understanding CSS styles. We will explore both of those options, but first and foremost, you need to understand that this is currently only available in Chrome Canary. My version of Canary currently is 1.32. So if you want to play around with AI features, you will have to download and use Chrome Canary. I will not bore you with those details, so let's jump right into code. I will close my settings in developer tools and I will open my console. Right here, I have a few errors on my page. Uncut resize observer loop. That sounds really bad, but AI might be able to help me with this. If I hover over this error, I will see this icon that will help me understand it using AI. Or alternatively, I can just right click and select understand this error from the context menu. The first time when you try to use AI features, you will get a message like this that explains a little bit about what's happening and what are the conditions of use. Of course, you can accept that, and then you'll be able to get an explanation of this particular resize observer loop error. Now, this is an in-depth explanation of the problem that I'm having on this particular page because AI can access its DOM tree, its code, and so on. So information that I get here is in the context of this page that I'm on. And this is the biggest advantage of AI built directly into developer tools because it understands exactly what your current state of the page is, and it can then give you some advice about fixing problems or improving the site. In this case, I will get an in-depth explanation about what this error might be, what the problem is, what potential solution might be. There's a lot of info here along with code examples that will help you understand better about how to fix that potential problem. This is actually really, really nice. We will not fix this error right now. I'll deal with it a little bit later. Let's try the second one, area hidden on element, understand this message. And I will get an explanation again, an in-depth explanation about what area hidden does, what the problem might be, and potential solutions. Now, when you're reading AI explanations and potential solutions, you will have to understand a little bit about code and you will have to judge for yourself if the solution AI presents is a good one or maybe not, because I've tested it a little bit and sometimes AI gets things wrong and can give you wrong suggestions or not ideal, not optimal suggestions. This is a very helpful tool that will give you ideas about the problems you might be having, but you still need to, well, use your own judgment about the solutions that AI will present you. AI can also help you understand your style sheets a little bit better and offer potential solutions. This is available in the Elements panel. I'll jump into it, and if you right-click on any node on your page, you will have a new option, Ask AI. If you select this option, you will be presented with a new drawer, AI Assistant, and right here, you can see immediately that the current node, or body, in my example, is selected. Let's select the first offered option. What can you help me with? It can take a little bit of time for the answers to arrive, but they are pretty good in my experience. If you want to understand exactly how AI analyzed your node, your question, you can open this tab and you'll see exactly what's happening. This selector is body, it has 7 child elements, and so on and so on. It's all contextual related to the page. All right, so let's close this and let's see exactly what the AI did. I can help you debug issues on your page, layout issues, visibility problems, stacking order, style conflicts, performance, accessibility, and more. So essentially, you can ask anything and AI should be able to help you. Let's test this out. I will scroll down here and find my stickers grid. And this is actually a story behind every sticker that is available in this sticker pack. And there are quite a lot of those stickers here. And each sticker, as you see, has its own image. But I'll tell you immediately, they are not optimized. So let's see if AI can help me figure out how to optimize this part of code. Let's inspect one of the images. I'm using plain image tag with one source and with an empty alt text. So what the AI should tell me right here is to lazy load those images. They are below default. There's a lot of those images, so I should be lazy loading them. And I should potentially add multiple sources for different screen sizes because those images right now are small. And if I close my developer tools, they are quite a bit bigger. So I should probably have different image sizes for different screen sizes. That way I should be able to improve the performance here. All right, let's jump back into developer tools and let's see if AI can figure that out. I'll select my images list. This is grid stickers element. And I'll ask AI, how can I optimize this? As you've seen, I didn't click directly on my image. I actually clicked on the unordered list element, which contains list items. And then in each list item, there is an image. So this is everything that AI did here. It analyzes grid, container, specific layout and rendering properties. It's giving me some advice about grid and so on. And here's image optimization. Since grid contains images, stickers, ensure that images are properly optimized for web views. And it even suggests WebP format. I'm using JPEG, so this is definitely a good suggestion. And here is lazy loading. So the next step might be to ask AI to clarify one of those points. For example, I wanted to tell me a little bit more about image optimization. Can you show me how to optimize image sizes? The observation shows that all images have a natural size of 600 by 500 pixels, but are displayed at 232 pixels. So that's not ideal. And that means that we're downloading larger images than necessary. Exactly what is happening here. Here's what we can do to optimize this. Resize images. All right. Yeah. Then use source set and sizes for responsive images. Perfect. And it shows me even an example. So this code provides three different images for those sizes. So those numbers seem a little bit random and I'm not sure if they are correct. I'm not using those responsive breakpoints, but this definitely is a good starting point. Then I can use WebP format, yes, and again, lazy loading, this is what I should do. So this is actually pretty nice. AI actually did give me some solid advice about improving the performance of my images section here. You can also ask AI general questions about the page itself. So I'll just select HTML element and I'll ask AI, what can I do to optimize this page? The AI will analyze my page structure and potential issues and it will give me examples. And one of the examples will probably be about images, about lazy loading images and optimizing those images. So let's see. Preload critical resources, good. And of course, it shows me exactly how to do this with my code. Defer non-critical scripts. I should do that. Like this should definitely be deferred. I don't need ConvertKit immediately. Then async non-critical scripts, yes. Again, good idea. Then we have optimize images. We already seen that. Reduce external resources. Okay. Cache resources. Wow. There's quite a lot of things that I can do to make this page better. And yeah, AI understands exactly what I'm not doing right or what I could be doing better based on my code. I think this is really great. You can also ask AI to help you implement a new feature on the page. For example, we can ask AI to give me a solution for implementing dark mode for this particular website. And if you want to learn more about that, Adiosmani has a fantastic overview here on YouTube. Link is going to be in the description. So check it out. He shows you in detail how AI can help you implement a dark mode for your website. It's pretty cool. And the next thing that I want to show you is how can AI help you fix some problems on your site? I do have one specific problem on this page that I want AI to fix. I will scroll back up here and here on my sticker sets, I have lightbox gallery. And if you notice, when I open it, my scroll bar disappears and my layout shifts. If you're following CSS Weekly, then you probably already know the solution for this. It's scroll bar gutter property. That's what I'm actually using. I just disabled it. I'll show you really quickly in the code here on my body element. I have commented out scroll bar gutter property. If I enable this, my content will not shift. It will work exactly as it should. But let's see if AI can give me that solution. I'll comment it out again and I will open my lightbox and I will ask AI, why did my layout shift when I opened the lightbox? The lightbox is adding classes to my HTML and body elements. Let's just use the body element and see exactly what AI can help me with. I'll clear this. Why is my layout shifting when I open the lightbox? So I see the state of AI response as paused here, and it's investigating lightbox and scrollbar effects. If I read this, it will tell me that it needs to inject some code into my page in order to understand a little bit better what's happening. And this is the code that it wants to execute. It's going to simulate opening and closing lightbox, and hopefully then it will understand what's happening. Whenever it needs to do something like this, whenever it needs to change the code, it will give you a warning and ability to stop it. If you don't want the AI to tweak your page, then you can cancel this request, or you can just allow it to continue and then see what happens. We have another pause, rechecking body dimensions after lightbox close. I'll again click continue. And it again wants to execute more code. Let's allow it. All right, so it did execute quite a lot of code, as you've seen, but here's the breakdown of why the layout is shifting and potential solutions. Okay, the lightbox implementation is modifying the body element styles. It's adding overflow hidden. Yes, exactly, that's what's happening, and that's why the layout is shifting, because the scroll bar disappears and the page expands to its position because we're adding overflow hidden. So here are the reasons why the layout is shifting. The lightbox is adding some classes. Okay, preserve scroll bar space. Okay, we can add overflow hidden on the body. Okay, this is a potential solution, but it's not exactly what I want. Use container element. Review lightbox styles. Yeah, I don't want to review third-party lightbox styles. Scroll bar library compatibility. Well, maybe we have a newer version of library. Okay. View transitions API. And the recommendation is to go with the first solution, preserving scroll bar space. So this will work, but it's not exactly what I want. I want to be using cutting-edge CSS features to fix this. So I will ask it directly if there are some cutting-edge CSS features that might help with this instead. View transitions API. Okay. Well, it did not figure out that we can use scrollbar gutter properties. So can we ask a better question to see if it will eventually figure it out? I'm not sure about this. Are there any simpler experimental CSS solutions? Right. Content visibility? No. Contain? No. What about scrollbar gutter? Still didn't figure it out. Let's ask another question. Is there a CSS solution to handle scrollbar size? I intentionally don't want to ask the correct question. I want to see if it can figure it out, and apparently it can. This is exactly what I want, scrollbar gutter, and example, scrollbar gutter stable. It gives me a warning that, yeah, it's relatively new and it might not be supported in all browsers, which is exactly right. It's not supported in Safari yet. It's only in technology preview. So let's say I don't know which browsers don't support scrollbar gutter. As of November 2023, here's the breakdown of browser support. So this is the feedback that I'm looking for, but it seems that the AI is trained on a dataset that is not as recent as it should be. So this might be one thing to notice, one warning. If you're using this AI, it might not know exactly what are the current features that you can use today. This might not be a big issue, because if you're working on a production level website, you anyway want to support pretty much all browsers, so if something is in the baseline, AI should know about it and should give you correct information. Now let's ask another really important question here, and let's see if AI can figure it out. I'm going to leave the selector as is. I'm going to clear my console, and I will ask, should I subscribe to CSS Weekly YouTube channel? This is not really relevant to this particular website or this particular node that we have selected, but it's a legitimate question, and the answer should be a resounding yes. Unfortunately, AI cannot figure it out. It's better at debugging web pages, it says. I'm 100% sure that you know better than AI, and that you already smashed that subscribe button. Thanks so much if you did. All right, let's try another thing before we wrap this up. I will close my lightbox. I will go into my elements panel, and I will scroll down here. At the bottom of my HTML, I have this invisible div. Its dimensions are 0, 0. It's positioned absolutely. And let's say I don't know why this div is here, and I want AI to help me with it. I'll right click it, I'll select Ask AI, I'll clear my out here, and I'll say, what is this div? It appears to be an empty placeholder for dynamically added content. Here are some observations about this div. It's empty and without attributes, you don't say. It's positioned absolutely with a high Z index. Exactly, it's very high. It's at the end of the body, has zero width and height. Therefore, it's probable that this div is either a placeholder, a container for dynamic content, or unintentionally left empty div. By further investigating, you will gain a better understanding. But can you do this for me? Well, if it has access to my code, it should be able to investigate for me, right? Okay, again, it wants to inject some code. If you read the explanation, you will understand exactly what it wants to do. But for now, let's just click continue. Deep dive into the div's purpose. Oh, I love this. Based on further investigation, it appears that div is currently not being actively used by JavaScript network requests or event listeners. Oh, I should check my Git history. Okay. Consult with the developers. I'm in DevTools. I am a developer. Why would you tell me to consult developers? This is not a helpful answer. All right. Let's give it a hint. Could it be related to the lightbox? All right. Again, it wants to inject some code. I'll continue. Despite the possibility, there is no direct evidence. Well, let's see for ourselves if it is related. It is not. So it figured it out correctly. This is div that is probably related to one of my other scripts, probably from Gumroad, because I'm injecting Gumroad into this page because that is the service that I'm using to sell those stickers. And by the way, you should be impressed by those stickers by now. And well, just look at those. If you don't order a pack, I'll be really disappointed. And I'll even give you a discount. You're going to find the code in the description here. In any case, if you do order a pack, you will directly help CSS Weekly and this particular channel, and you'll have my eternal gratitude. In any case, let's wrap this introduction to AI in Chrome DevTools. I think it's pretty great. I think it's very helpful, and I think I'll be using this constantly. If you're trying to debug something, it will give you context-aware information about your page, so you don't have to search for an answer elsewhere on the internet. You can directly inspect the code, ask AI about potential problems, but potential solutions to problems you're having, and you might get a direct solution, or you might get some hints about possible solutions that you could implement. Of course, as with everything related to AI, use your own judgment. You should be able to understand what good, appropriate answers are and what might not be an ideal solution, or that there might be a better solution if AI presents something that seems a little bit off. In any case, I think this works pretty great. I'm really happy that I can show this off to you, and I'm really excited that I get to use this in Chrome DevTools. Yeah, as somebody who is not particularly impressed by AI features that all apps are pushing these days, I think this is pretty great. But what do you think? Will you try it out? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different Chrome DevTools AI feature, or rather, in the next video, and specifically in the one that you'll see on the screen right now. Thanks so much. Bye.